Hi, it's Hannah from Printful's marketing team. In this video, I'll show you how to create a tie-dye design print file that you can use on your all-over print products. I'll start by creating a new large square file in Photoshop with 6,000 pixels in width and length and resolution set to 300. I'll set the color mode to CMYK color and press Create. Next, I'll select the Rectangle tool and click on the canvas to create a rectangle. A new window will open up where I'll set the width to 1,200 pixels, height to 6,000 pixels, and press OK. Now I'll switch to the Move tool and press Control or Command A to select everything in this layer. This will enable the alignment panel where I'll click on Align Horizontal Centers and Align Left Edges. This will help me to properly align the shape layer in the canvas. I'll press Control or Command D to deselect the layer. In the layer panel, I'll double-click on the layer thumbnail to change its color. When you're creating your rectangle shapes, make sure you don't have stroke color selected. To do that, head over to the Properties tab located here, and under Appearance, where it says Stroke, make sure to select the No Color icon. Next, I'll duplicate this shape layer 4 times by pressing Control or Command J, rename each copied shape, position them next to each other, align them horizontally, and change their colors. With that done, I'll hold down Control or Command, select all the created shape layers in the Layers tab, right-click, and choose Convert to Smart Object to merge all the shapes. With the new layer selected, I'll head over to the Filter tab located here, hover over Distort, and select Polar Coordinates. This will open up a new window where I'll select the Rectangle to Polar option and press OK. This will distort my vertical shapes and create a circular image. Now I'll head over to the Filter tab again, hover over Blur, and click on Gaussian Blur. A new window will open up where I'll set the blur radius to 50 pixels and press OK. Next, in the Filter tab under Distort, I'll select Twirl. In a new window, I'll set the angle value to minus 600 and press OK. Since I won't be using the background layer, I'll unlock it by clicking on the lock icon and remove it by pressing Delete. With that done, let's head over to Image, hover over Mode, and select RGB Color. A new window will appear, where I'll press Rasterize. Now that I have all my assets ready, I'll go to the Filter tab and click on Liquify. This will open up a new window where I'll create the tie-dye effect. First up, I'll click on the Pin Edges checkbox located here. This will prevent the transparent background from appearing when I apply the effects. I'll start by selecting the Forward Warp tool, set the brush size to 300, density to 100, and start drawing vertical streaks from the center of the image. I can change the brush size to get warp streaks of different sizes. In my example, the colors mixed in the center occupied too much space. To minimize the diameter of this area, I'll select the Pucker tool and apply the brush to the center of the image. With that done, let's finish up by selecting the Twirl Clockwise tool. Set the brush size to 8,000 pixels, density to 5, rate to the maximum value, and apply the brush to the center of the image. As you can see, the image starts twirling in a clockwise motion, blending all the color streaks that I've created. Now I'll press OK to finalize my design. Now all that's left is to export the design as a JPEG and create a product on Printful by following the link under this video. This will open up our Design Maker, where I'll click on the Home and Living category, choose Pillows, and select the All Over Print Premium Pillow. For this example, I'll select the 18x18 size, set the stitch color to white, and drag my image over to where it says Drop Your Design Here. Once the image is loaded, I'll click on Duplicate and select Back Print. This way, the design will appear on both sides of the pillow. Lastly, you can save the product as a template and then add it to your store or proceed to checkout. If you want to see more tutorials about other design trends, subscribe to our channel and turn on the notifications. Now that you know how to create the tie-dye effect, which all-over print products will you try it out on? Tell me about it in the comments.